Hi, I'm back with another vlog. Today I'm going to be taking a look at which club kids were connected to the Pater Gatien trial and how they were involved. So if you don't know who Pater Gatien is, he was a club owner and party promoter and was once dubbed the King of New York Clubs. He had an impressive list of properties owning Club USA, the Palladium, Tunnel, and the Limelight. The trial centered mostly on the goings-on at the Limelight. So in the mid-90s, the Limelight was raided by federal agents and it was padlocked. The investigation that followed turned into Pater Gatien getting charged with drug racketeering, and the trial dragged on for more than 4 weeks. Most of the information that I'm going to be discussing with you today will come from two sources. One is Nightclubs, Down and Dirty, published in February of 1998 by Frank Owen for the Washington Post, and the 2011 documentary Limelight, which was produced by Gatien's daughter, Jen. I will share a link to the article below. So, in regards to Cynthia Hataja, or Gitsy, the Washington Post writes, quote, "Limelight regular Cynthia Hataja, aka Gitsy, was slated to be a defense witness. Hataja recently appeared in Party Monster, a documentary about Alec, but Hataja never testified. She overdosed on heroin and was found dead in her Queens apartment just a few days before the trial got underway." So this is interesting because I thought that Gitsy was going to be a potential witness for the prosecution, and according to this article, that is not correct. I guess she was slated to be a defense witness on behalf of Pater Gatien. So I'm definitely going to look to see if I can confirm that, and if so, I'm going to go back and put some corrections in the descriptions of those videos. So on genitalia, the Post writes, quote, "The government's case may not have been helped by several of its own witnesses either. Jenny Denbro attended the lavish private parties that Alec and Gatien threw at posh Manhattan hotels like the Mayfair and the Four Seasons. Other witnesses testified that the wild shindigs, champagne, caviar, and piles of drugs. Once on the stand, Denbro, formerly a close friend of Gatien's, recalled some of the more innocent aspects of the party, such as Alec building a fort out of the hotel sheets and furniture, but she developed amnesia about the more sordid details. I don't remember, I was on drugs at the time," said Denbro. So it's also been reported that Pater Gatien was having an extramarital affair with Jenny Denbro prior to the trial. So here's what the article wrote about Brooke Humphreys. Quote, "During the government's opening statements, prosecutor Michelle Adelman offered a dramatic warning to the jury. You might be shocked and disgusted by the appearance of some of these club kids," she said. Adelman was referring to the body piercings and dyed hair of Brooke Humphreys, a regular at Disco 2000 Nights, who was expected to testify that Alec told her that Gatien coordinated drug dealings at the clubs. Hearsay is admissible under the RICO statute under which Gatien was charged. Humphreys did indeed make a strong impression during the course of the trial, but not in the way Adelman predicted. 2 days before she was due to take the stand, Humphreys was charged with making false statements to federal officials. She told them she had not resumed selling drugs in violation of her cooperation agreement with prosecutors. Humphreys had previously pleaded guilty to drug charges and in exchange for leniency was helping the government against Gatien. Humphreys wasn't the only witness who never made it to the stand. So I know that someone has asked me recently to take a look into Brooke Humphreys, and I actually have. There is some more information about her, so I probably will be doing a video on her in a little bit, but she did spend several years in prison for this. So in regards to Michael Alec, the article goes on to describe Alec as one of a trio of confidential informants who provided the government with damaging material about the drug dealing at Gatien's clubs in the early stages of the investigation, but, quote, "who all turned on their handlers alleging government misconduct. There was also no Matt Germanowski, the DE agent who infiltrated the drug scene at the Limelight. He was scratched from the witness list at the last minute. Prosecutors may have been aware that Brafman was intending to cross-examine the DEA agent about Alec's allegation made in court affidavit that Germanowski and his partner Bob Gagne allowed Alec to use heroin in the backseat of their car. So Michael Alec is actually interviewed in the 2011 Limelight documentary, and he did confirm this. He said that they would pick him up when he was going through withdrawals, they would drive him to meet his dealer, and then would go take a walk when the dealer arrived. So he also claimed that part of the reason why he decided not to testify against Gatien was because the prosecutors wanted him to lie on the witness stand. Here is what Screamin' Rachel had to say in regards to the Pater Gatien trial. I think it was crazy that Gitsy died before testifying. The trial was mostly about Pater Gatien. Basically, once again, I never saw Gatien do drugs. His daughters pulled me aside after the fact on my way into Jellybean's party at Tunnel. They were screaming that I said horrible things about their dad. When I told them what happened, they calmed down. The reason for immunity was that I consulted an attorney who advised me that others could point the finger at me about dealing and drugs, mainly to get themselves off. So I believe this is in regards to Screaming Rachel having to testify before the grand jury, and I would like to thank Screaming Rachel for sharing that information. The article also goes on to list the It Twins as drug dealers who testified for the prosecution, although it doesn't offer any quotes from their testimony, and I cannot find any other information at the current time about the extent of their involvement or what was said. So that's pretty much all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this video. I want to thank you for watching and for all the support, likes, and shares. And you can definitely check out some of my other videos or playlists. And if you have not yet subscribed, you can do so by clicking the kitty. And I will see you again for my next upload.